All right, let's return to this reversal of sorts from Labor when it comes to gas. And I say of sorts because I'm not convinced that her colleagues are going to back Madeleine King, the Resources Minister, as they should. Let's bring in the Australian's Environment Editor, Graham Lloyd. I'll get to the politics in a moment, Graham, but please, in broad terms, what's this announcement today all about?
Well, good evening, Peter. In broad terms, this is an announcement that says Labor agrees with all those sensible things that we've been talking about, to increase supply of gas, to back up renewables if you're going to build them, to make it available for industry so we can have a competitive manufacturing sector, and to keep selling gas to all our foreign customers to play our part in the global decarbonisation and also underpin the budget. So in a sense, this is a suite of reforms that, if put in place, you'd have to say would be very good.
Well, that's good to know. We haven't been wasting our time, you and I, Graham. I'm a bit sceptical. King says, I hope the policy is shared by my cabinet colleagues. I want to hope they will come with her on this. What do you think?
Well, I think there's tough politics here, Peter. It's, you know, very likely that a good number of her colleagues will not support her. We've seen backbenchers come out today and try and distance themselves from it because they're concerned about their seats, and the Teals and the Greens have all come out in opposition. And I've got to say, all through today, I've been deluged with emails from all the peak environment groups and climate groups, and they are all declaring war on this new gas policy. They don't like it. They're going to fight against it. So Madeleine King is going to need some real support from Anthony Albanese and others to hold the nerve if she wants to get this through.
Mm. And just quickly, I mean, it's completely at odds with Labor in Victoria, who wants to basically ban the barbecue, ban the gas cooktop, can't use it for heating, but it's now all systems go in Canberra. It doesn't make sense.
No, that's right. And I think one of the refreshing things was the commitment to freedom of choice by families, how they want to heat and run their households. Madeleine King made it clear that she supports the use of gas as an option there, which is something that will come as a great surprise to Victoria.
Talk to me about this significant High Court judgment that's ruled that Australia's National Parks Authority can be criminally prosecuted for damaging sacred sites in the NT. What concerns me here is we've already, Graham, got a whole lot of bureaucrats who run our national parks, closing the gates now, worried about, you know, Mount Arapiles and rock climbers and damage to sacred sites, not just sacred sites, but just the fact that the park has Indigenous history in it, shutting down our access if we're not Indigenous Australians. Won't this make the National Park bureaucrats even more reluctant to keep the parks open as they are now?
Well, I think it's going to concentrate the mind of anybody who has to now take authority and responsibility. We're seeing a transfer of management and responsibility of national parks over to Indigenous groups. We're seeing a lot of lawfare in the area to try and prosecute issues of land management. I think this is a very fraught area for any bureaucrat to make a decision. And if it's backed up with potential criminal charges if they get it wrong, I think they're going to be very wary.